Here is another principle of yin and yang. 阴阳消长，量变。Yin and yang consume one another. Quantitative change. 阴阳消长还可以翻译为 Waxing and waning of yin and yang. 阴阳消长指阴阳双方的量不是一成不变的，而是处于不断的增长和消减的变化之中。阴阳消长的形式有两种，一是阴阳互为消长，二是阴阳皆消皆长。Waxing and waning of yin and yang means that the two aspects of yin and yang are always kept in a relative dynamic equilibrium to a certain range in the constant movement and change in which one wanes, decreases, while the other waxes, increases.例如一天之中从子时至午时是阴消阳长的表现，从午时至子时是阳消阴长的表现。阴消阳长
Yin waning while yang waxing
阳消阴长
Yang waning while yin waxingAfter noon, as the darkness grows and the light lessens, yin consumes yang. After midnight, as darkness lessens and light grows, yang consumes yin. Each consumes the other.
四季变换也体现出阴阳互为消长，从冬至春及夏，气候从寒冷逐渐转暖变热。这就是阳长阴消。
Yang waxing while yin waning.
由夏至秋及冬，气候由炎热逐渐转凉变寒，这就是阴长阳消。
Yin waxing while yang waning. Think of the change of seasons, for example.The weather gets warm when winter gives way to spring, and hot when spring gives way to summer, during which time yin wanes while yang waxes. When summer is gradually replaced by winter again, yang wanes while yin waxes.
这是北京市全年降雨量的示意图，从图中可以看出随着春夏气温的逐渐升高，降雨量逐渐增多，这就是阴随阳长。这是上海市的全年降雨量示意图。随着秋冬气候的逐渐转凉，降雨量逐渐减少，这就是阴随阳消。阴随阳长。
Yin waxing while yang waxing.
阴随阳消
Yin waning while yang waning
人体也有阴阳皆消皆长的时候，比如说人饥饿时出现气力不足，既是由于阴精不足不能化生阳气而致阳也不足，这就是阳随阴消的变化。人吃东西补充了营养物质阴化生能量阳，就会增长气力，则是阴得补充又能生阳，这就是阳随阴长的变化。
When you are hungry, you probably don't feel like doing anything except eating. Yin is insufficient, yang is deficient. This is called yang waning while yin waning. Once you've eaten a delicious meal and you're stuffed, you probably feel energized and ready to do something for once.This is called yang waxing while yin waxing. If you don't eat, the yin and yang in your body will continue to decrease until there's nothing left. When there's nothing left, you die. So make sure that when you're hungry, you go eat something. Same thing for when you're thirsty, go drink something. Let's look at another principle of yin yang.
阴阳互化，质变。
Yin and yang can transform into one another. qualitative change.
阴阳消长是事物的量变过程，阴阳转化是事物的质变过程。
The waning and waxing of yin and yang is a process of quantitative change, while transformation of yin and yang is a process of qualitative change based on the quantitative change.
阴阳的消长和转换是事物发展变化过程中密不可分的两个阶段。阴阳消长是阴阳转化的前提，而阴阳转化则是阴阳消长的必然结果。
The waxing and waning of the mutual transformation of yin and yang may be regarded as two inseparable stages of development. Waxing and waning are the necessary precondition for transformation, and transformation is the necessary result of waxing and waning.
相互对立的阴阳双方在一定条件下可各自向其对立面转化，不具备一定的条件，两者就不能各自向相反的方向转化。
Yin can change into yang and vice versa. This change does not happen at random, but only at a certain stage of development of something. The transformation of yin and yang happen under two conditions. The first is internal condition. Things can change only through internal causes primarily, and external causes secondarily. For example, an egg changes into a chick with the application of heat only because the egg contains within itself the capacity of turning into a chick. Application of heat to a stone will not produce a chick. If you are trying to do this, please, I suggest you go back to school, preferably the first grade. Wood can turn into coal, but a stone cannot.If you're trying to turn a stone into coal, again, I suggest please go back to school, maybe not even first grade, maybe even kindergarten, or even pre-K if you really need it. The second condition is the time factor. Yin and yang can transform into each other only at certain stages of development when conditions are ripe for the change. Day cannot turn into night at any time.But only when it has reached its point of exhaustion. The chick will hatch only when the time is ripe.
阴阳转换的方式可以是渐变过程，也可以是因某突发事件引发的突发过程。
The transformation of yin yang can be a gradual process.Such as the alternation of cold and warm during the four seasons. It can also appear to be a sudden process, such as the sudden shock or fainting, as well as the cold extremities during the acute febrile disease symptoms change suddenly from yang to yin. No matter which kind of form it converses, it will always experience a process from quantitative change to qualitative change.This is the last principle of yin-yang. Everything contains the seed of its apparent opposite.
阴阳互含，或阴阳互藏，或阴阳互育。阴阳互藏是指相互对立的阴阳双方中的任何一方都蕴含着另一方，即阴中有阳，阳中有阴。任何事物和现象都含有阴与阳两种属性不同的成分，属阳的事物含有阴性成分，属阴的事物也含有阳性成分。类经运气类说，天本阳也，然阳中有阴；地本阴也，然阴中有阳。此阴阳互藏之道。昼为阳，夜为阴。而上午与下午相对而言，则上午为阳中之阳，下午为阳中之阴。前半夜与后半夜相对而言，则前半夜为阴中之阴，后半夜为阴中之阳。
Day is considered yang and night is yin. However, morning is understood as being yang within yang.Afternoon is yin within yang. evening before midnight is yin within yin, and the time after midnight is yang within yin.
看一下你的手掌，一个大拇指是奇数为阳，但它是两节的，这叫做阳中有阴。四个手指是偶数为阴，但每个手指都是三节的，这叫做阴中有阳。
Look at one of your hands. Your thumb is probably stronger than your four fingers, as you could push a thumbtack easily into a wall or a wooden board. Hence, thumb is yang, fingers are yin. In addition, on each hand, you have one thumb and four fingers. As we know, the odd number one is considered as yang. The even number four is yin, hence thumb is yang, fingers are yin. However, a thumb has two knuckle joints. The even number two is yin. Your thumb represents yin within yang. Each finger has three knuckle joints. The odd number three is yang, hence your fingers represent yang within yin.
火明为阳，但火中内暗，即阳中有阴。
Fire is bright outside and dark inside. Hence there is yin within yang.
Gang zhong dai rou.
Softness within toughness.
Rou zhong dai gang.
Toughness within softness.
Dong zhong yu jing.
Stillness within motion.
Jing zhong yu dong.
Motion within stillness. Finding harmony in change, the wisdom of yin and yang. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, share, subscribe, comment, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys!